The year 1956, and during the Suez Crisis, the world stands on the brink of a nuclear war. In Hungary, the people's uprising is crushed by the Red Army with tanks. In Monaco, the actress Grace Kelly marries Prince Rainer III. And with the top-class model, the 220S, the letter S gains permanent entry into the model designation collection of Mercedes-Benz. The Mercedes S-Class, the epitome of luxury, comfort, and safety. The S-Class sets the standard for prestige and technology. Every model is a bestseller. Every model the status symbol of the rich and powerful. The S-Class is a phenomenon.
The S-Class is the pinnacle of automotive technology. That was true in the past and it will remain so in the future.
The winner in the toughest international stress test, Mercedes-Benz. The winner, however, is every purchaser of a Mercedes-Benz car because the experience gained is benefited from in all vehicles bearing the Mercedes-Benz star. A test drive with Mercedes-Benz 300, from which the world-famous 300 SL racing sports car was developed. You will be convinced by the excellent driving performance. You will honestly be surprised and well-rested coming into the conference like these two gentlemen.
The Mercedes 300, luxury sedan and mobile pride of post-war Germany. It embodies like no other automobile the we are again somebody feeling. Chancellor Konrad Adenauer makes it the state vehicle. The Adenauer Mercedes is in the fleets of the Pope, politicians and celebrities, a supercar.
That was a different dimension. It was simply so high up that they said, okay, this is nothing for ordinary people. It was simply for VIPs, royalty, and in the end, too aloof.
The aloof flagship is still considered the forerunner for the later S-Class. Economic miracle. Based on the 180 Ponton, in 1956, Mercedes presented the 220S. A six-cylinder engine, stretched body, and a previously unknown interior comfort make the 220S a luxury car. The first Mercedes after the war with S, signifying special class status. It cost 12,500 marks then to move into the luxury car class.
Well, it was luxury at a time where it was not easy, of course. But you have to say Mercedes looked far ahead and did not shy away from opening up their pot of luxury again.
The first official crash test with the new Mercedes luxury class model was held on September 10, 1959. With over 15,000 deaths per year, safety becomes a major selling point. And the new S models are the first production cars to feature a safety body and crumple zone. They lay the foundation for modern car safety technology. New safety standards were also set in the interior, with impact absorbers on the steering wheel made from soft plastic or rubber. The new six-cylinder engine, a class for itself. So was the slogan for the series with the internal designation W111/112, better known as the tailfin. The 220S reflects the fashion of its time, elegant but not too provocative.
The tailfin was the best car that you could buy at that time because of its technology, because of its durability, its quality, and its safety equipment. And of course, because one had clearly improved in comfort.
The tail fin drives as good as it looks. The press wrote at the time, the 220 SE has been designed to transport 5 people and their luggage over long distances in comfort, as only few other cars can. The top model, the 300 SE, even has an air suspension. And on rally courses, the luxury sedan shows its opponents its tail fins. It won the 1960 Monte Carlo Rally, also the European Rally Championship twice, and the murderous Gran Premio, or Grand Prize, in Argentina. The S-Class of the 60s, simple and timeless, for many, the most beautiful Mercedes with an S in the model number, serial W108/109. Clean lines, refined elegance, produced by design artist Paul Brack. The series W108/109 established a place for itself among the immortal automotive classics.
The smooth tail fin ended up with clean lines, large windows, and there I'd say the designers once again produced a great success.
The Big Gamble is the first independent luxury class series from Mercedes. Mercedes sees the actual birth of the S-Class with the series W108/109.
The S-Class is always for me, I'd say, for people who have achieved something in business, like the entrepreneur. He buys a car like that. And for me, that's the concept of the S-Class.
Technically, the W108 is largely based on the previous model. There is some progress, but in the safety technology department, from 1967, the S has a safety steering column which collapsed telescopically upon impact. In addition, 3-point belts are also available. More car and more engine. In the extended SEL versions, the American principal rules, displacement is irreplaceable except by displacement. So especially the 300 SEL 6.3 is the superlative S-Class. The 6.3-litre V8 makes the 300 SEL the then fastest production sedan in the world with 250 horsepower and a top speed of 220. A nightmare for any Porsche driver. The 6.3-litre engine develops power from the fall and soon finds its way to the racetrack.
The untamable 6.3-litre was only otherwise available in America, and this was another bold statement with the S-Class in these dimensions. And the engine came out of the 600. Ultimately, it comes from the top, and it's still an icon, of course.
Mercedes tuner AMG tuned the icon even further and started with a 300 SEL 6.8 in 1971 at the 24-hour race at Spa. The legendary Red Pig ends up second in the overall standings. They are the beautiful sisters of the S-Class, the coupes and convertibles of the series W108/109. At that time, avant-garde. Today, the elegant lines still unmatched. The coupe and convertible change every boulevard to concours d'élégance. The Mercedes 600, here in the Pullman version, in the 60s, the crowning glory of the Swabian automotive house. It's technically ahead of its time and also accepted as a technology platform for the next S-Class. Financially incremental business, it is produced for a long time because of its prestige.
Show stars, celebrities and dictators, of course, loved a large car, and thus it was built until 78.
The year is 1972, and it's 3 years after the moon landing. Technically now, everything seems possible. And the best example is the new top model from Mercedes, the first official S-Class. In terms of technology and safety, comfort and design, it is seen as being unrivaled in its commanding presence, offers the highest prestige. World class, cheers the trade press.
The 116 was a completely separate car. It was not based on its predecessor like the previous ones. It was a completely new design. It was bigger, it was more solidly built. It was considered as being the most perfect and best car in the world in its time.
The S-Class made electronics in the automotive industry socially acceptable. Electric windows, electric sunroof, cruise control and climate control in 1972. Later, the W116 series was the first car in the world with anti-lock braking system, ABS. The tank of the S-Class is crash-protected and sits above the rear axle. The idea of the safety steering system is perfected. Inside, the steering wheel sits with a buttery-soft dash pod. Plus, there is a recessed switch and a heavily padded instrument panel. The headlamp cleaning system is as new as the pollution-poor side windows. The flagship S-Class is not a 6, but an 8-cylinder engine, the SEL 6.9 450.
That was the 450 SEL 6.9, the super S-Class car in this period. It came onto the market with some delay in 1975 and was also the top model of its time.
The new S-Class, the model W126 from 1979, is almost the complete car, especially in the field of safety. After more than 250 crash tests, 2,500 sledge tests, and over 7 million test kilometers, the airbag is ready for mass production in late 1980. Mercedes offers it along with the new seatbelt pre-tensioners for the first time in the new S-Class. Chief designer Bruno Sacco creates a timeless classic, the series produced longer than any other S-Class for almost 12 years.
The W126 was a dynamic announcement. It was athletic, it was a dynamic, modern car with an almost peerless drag coefficient value. It had completely new technology and was a new way to show off Mercedes design. It was a great fit in its time with these plastic bumpers, and so that was just up to date then. And the entire design language of this car is smooth, simple, not overdone, but still inside as cream and quality as one would expect from Mercedes.
The W126 is sold 818,000 times around the world, a unique record for a luxury class car. The Coupe S-Class would be built almost 75,000 times. The SEC, which in 1971 pushed the sedan to the side.
all modern cars have the same problems. For example, any bottle is superior to the car in one point. A bottle may already be fully recycled today. In terms of safety, nature is a million years ahead of the car. Because who is protected well in his car from all sides? It is namely no longer to be overlooked. People in cars have completely grown apart in the last 100 years. It is time for the new S-Class. The largest S-Class of all time, the model W140 from 1991, a controversial car right from the start.
The design of the W140 was completely perfect, but it didn't necessarily please. I can't be too enthusiastic there. To me, it's simply too coarse, large, no design behind it, really. The design language then was a huge box.
Too pretentious and too chunky, not timely. Some of the critique of the W140. That said, the W140 S-Class is the superlative, the ultimate automobile. Its complex design chassis brings maximum comfort. Plus, there is perfect acoustic insulation. The W140 is already equipped with a CAN bus. It is crammed with electrical workers and microelectronics. The cockpit is luxurious, elegant, and perfectly processed. There is a navigation system, an electronic parking aid, and an easy-to-use electric seat adjustment. Another new feature is the belt system with automatic height adjustment, and in addition to the front airbags, side airbags for driver and passenger. The Electronic Stability Program, or ESP, was introduced as a world's first in the S-Class Coupe C140 in 1995.
The W140 had, like the Porsche 944, far too many designers. One worked focused on the car, without realizing the real technical brilliance.
Even though over 400,000 buyers recognize the technical brilliance of the large ship. The S-Class model W220, 1998, the new beginning of the luxury series. About 30 new developments go into production, and the new S-Class has been recognized as the best car in the world. The audience is amazed, not only by the high tech, but also by the delicate design. The new S is the smooth counterpart to the powerful predecessor.
Certainly politically correct, because it was in fact not a real S-Class. It was an S-Class which brought technology and a high technical standard. It was visually elegant, it was handsome, but it was saying nothing.
Understatement fits to the time. The W220 sold better than its predecessor. A new era in vehicle safety began from the 2002 model year, with the anticipatory occupant protection system PreSafe that launches independent measures to protect passengers if an accident is imminent.
This is the first time that we wanted to integrate active safety with passive safety. It's basically a system that reacts to dangerous situations, such as people or animals respond reflexively to dangerous situations. And then in this case, a belt tensioner is activated. Or the seats on the passenger side can be adjusted and the sunroof closes itself.
Also new is electronically controlled air suspension system that enhances comfort and the agility of the S-Class.
This, of course, is the suspension which beats absolutely everything.
The S400 CDI, the powerful 8-cylinder with 250 horsepower, with a speed of 250, the 400 CDI became the fastest high-volume diesel in the world. The model W220, the best car in the world, is not quite as perfect as it seems. The S-Class rusts. It's the time of slump in quality at Mercedes. Nevertheless, the W220 is, at the time, the most successful car in the luxury class worldwide.
The W221 is actually a direct successor if you think of the W140. It's come back to its former size. It's again a typical S-Class. It's in the wind.
The new S-Class model W221 comes in 2005. No trace of understatement, the W221 series is again a typical flagship. The standard meter, the luxury, the car of the upper crust. Despite a low drag value of 0.26, the S-Class blatantly shows how status on four-wheel looks. It is also more than ever again the technology carrier from Mercedes. In the S-Class, the vision drives from safe, accident-free driving. Electronic helpers such as blind spot assist, lane keeping assist, and speed limit assist bring the car closer to this ideal. The rich and the important use the S-Class sedan like a chauffeur limousine, the rear side bags to protect clients in a crash. Particularly innovative is the active night vision assistant with sophisticated infrared technology from the military circles. Even cold objects can be seen in the dark, so bring more light into the darkness for all nocturnals. The Night View Assist is an extra that is even in the master of all classes, in the Mercedes X600, only optional. For this, the X600 offers for travel in the luxury class Olympics a longer wheelbase, 12 combustion chambers, and 517 horsepower. The top S-Class, a one-ton heavyweight, all-round happy package with a push of 830 Newton-meter. It even takes on a Porsche when accelerating. The W221 series is like its predecessors, the most successful luxury saloon for its time in the upper class.
The overall concept of the S-Class in engineering, in design, in stability is always over the top, over what you could buy for money.
More than 3 million S-Class over Mercedes cars have been sold since the first 220S. The S-Class is an expression of a lifestyle. You choose not to buy one, but rather the S-Class is ready when life has set the right course for you.